FM and Traffic Watch on WRFM, brought to you by Rapid Cabs, 85 85 85.
Thanks, Matt. Talk to you later.
Weather on WLRFM. Thanks to Cresthaven. Dreaming of basking in the early morning sun or enjoying a long summer's evening? Bring your dream to life with a Cresthaven conservatory.
Sunny spells and a few scattered showers. Top temperatures 18 to 20 degrees. In a moderate to fresh southwest wind. Mostly dry tonight with clear spells. And minimum temperatures of 10 to 13 degrees. A few scattered showers at first tomorrow. More persistent rain spreading eastwards in the evening. And top temperatures tomorrow 16 to 18 degrees Celsius. The next high tide in the city will be at 11 o'clock this evening. In Cheek Point at 10:25. In Tramore and Dunmore at 10:15. And in Dungarvan, Yole and Ardmore at 10:10 p.m.
High tides on WLRFM in association with County Clink Ferries. For really low prices going to France this summer, visit www.celticlinkferries.com. Nocturne till 7 with Ian Nocturne on WLRFM. Thanks to Woody's DIY and Garden Centre on the Cork Road. For a sizzling summer in the garden, see Woody's range of barbecues and garden furniture.
Now, on the programme this hour, we'll be looking at the latest live register figures, which show that in the last month alone, 600 people lost their jobs here in Waterford City and County. We'll also be talking about the tall ships. Just 1 year to go today, and the tall ships will be here in all their glory in Waterford. Looking forward to hearing about that. Sheridan Burr, the writer for Champions of Europe's Premier Football magazine, will be talking to us about the World Cup quarterfinals, particularly that upset there with Holland going in as underdogs and coming out as winners against Brazil. And we'll also be talking to Pierce Flynn, the Park Hotel, about celebrating 20 years in business on Sunday coming. So do stay tuned for that. Music first, this time from Brian Adams. Knock until 7, Waterford's WLRFM. Figures so starkly that every day last month of June in Waterford, 20 people lost their jobs. Well, in fact, 20 people went on the live register, but could more people have lost their jobs, and could these figures be being shielded, I by the reality of emigration and also the fact that people who are self-employed won't be entitled to any social welfare benefits and therefore probably won't appear on that live register figures. Well, joining me now that I can talk more with this is Mark Fielding from ESME. Mark, you're very welcome back to the programme.
Thanks very much, Ian.
Is it a case, do you think, that those figures could be less than reality?
I think everybody has to acknowledge that the figures that are announced, number one, it's disguised, I suppose, or masked by the fact that we've lost probably somewhere around 60,000 people to immigration, mostly young Irish people. We have many, many people staying on in education who would normally be available for work, who are not now counted on the live register. And then we have thousands of people on false leave, again, are not, even though they're unemployed, they're being trained, but again, they're not on the live register. So the total figure, while it was announced, was 450,000 for the country. It's probably above 500,000.